Hello everybody, welcome again to our laboratory practical session at Springfield College of Healthcare Brampton. Today in this series we are going to discuss about the blood collection using the appropriate procedure and technique and sharp disposal. So first we have a look at the main commonly used technique, which is the vacutainer system. I'm going to show you first the component part. The discussion about the technique will be doing in the another next part. But first we have a look at the these are the vacutainer systems part component, which are the tube holder, also known as the needle holder. At one end it attaches the needle on this side, and this side goes the tube. So this is called tube holder or needle holder. Second comes the needles. The commonly used needles for the vacutainer systems are 21 gauge, which is green, and black 22 gauge. So 21 and 22 gauge are the most commonly used gauges. So this is, you can see, other side it's a white one, this side the colored portion. So here we can see how this looks. So these both needles are without safety feature. I'm going to show you the another needle which is having a safety feature. This one is having a safety feature. So here you can see, this is the portion, the pink color, this is safety feature, which is having a two purpose. One is showing you as a guidance for the bevel side up needle, how we can use it, that we are going to show during the technique. So this is the needle, the component, which is going to, later on once we complete the process, we are going to flip it back and going to use as the safety guard. So this is with the safety feature needle. That was about the vacutainer system. Second system which may have to use as an alternative system is the syringe. Here you can see, this is the commonly used syringe. How we use it, that also I'm going to show you in the next part. But this is the, you must have seen, this is the normal syringe. Different type, different size of the needles are also available. Generally for the serum collection, you might require 3 to 5 cc of the blood. So this is the needle and syringe. This is the needle part, this is the syringe part. So this we can use if we have to go for the larger collection, like for the PRP, we might be needing the bigger size of the syringe. But general collections, we may not require this much amount of blood. Then we go to the transfer hub system. This is another type. If you look at this, this is written transfer hub. Again, I'm going to discuss it during the technique when we will collect. I would like to show you. This is the transfer hub. This looks quite similar to our vacuum holder or tube holder, needle holder, but this is different. This is the fixed component. How we use that we'll see later on, but this is also the transfer hub we are using. This is another technique. Then we also use the butterfly. When we talk about the butterfly, might be familiar, sometimes we are using it for the collapsible type of veins or geriatric or pediatric patients. So there we can use a very small type of butterfly. Different gauges comes with the different colors. So as we see, the number increases, size decreases. So inverse relation is there. Another side, another one is a 23 gauge needle for the butterfly, which is very commonly used, particularly when you are using for the dorsal hand veins. So this is the butterfly. How to use this one, that we will discuss in the techniques. Just to have a look at that, how the butterfly looks. This also having a safety feature. So here you see, once the work is completed, you can just flip it back and this is gone. So this you can discard in the sharp container. So these are the different techniques we talked about. And the last point is the sharp disposal. So when it comes to the sharp disposal, you can have a look at this. This is our sharp disposal container. Sharp container could be of different colors also. It could be generally red color or a yellow one like this one. Always remember, this should never go, never feel beyond this level. More than 3/4 level, filling up that beyond that level is a very harmful and hazardous. So remember how to discard it, and it need to be immediately discarded once the procedure is over. Thank you, and we are going to discuss in the next session how the techniques and what are the different aspects of the phlebotomy which are important for the best practice of phlebotomy. Thank you, have a great day.